I think we've seen those games throughout the 2020 campaign. They don't think that they don't want the American people to hear directly from, you know, the biggest leader of the greatest political movement in our history. So I do suspect they'll try to, you know, censor and cut away. However, the people are anxious to hear from him. I mean, we do not have the First Amendment. It's under attack.
Okay, I understand that there's not a single right winger. There's scarcely anybody in America who actually understands what the First Amendment is about. But there is no constitutional right to having major broadcast news networks playing the entirety of your live speech. That's not in there. I don't know how it would be. The founding fathers had never heard of MSNBC. That's just not a thing. It's not censorship for them to cut away or to not broadcast it at all. There are lots of speeches going on as I sit here. Lots of speeches will be made. You don't have to cover all of them. And by the way, many of the networks did play significant portions of it. Yes, some cut away, and I will add, you know, Fox News was one of those. And by the way, Rupert Murdoch has apparently told Trump that he and Fox News will not be defending Trump and supporting him during this presidential bid. But again, Liz, that is not at all what the First Amendment is about. That's a ridiculous claim to make.
Isn't that a horrible admission by Murdoch? We will not be supporting and defending him this time around, which means you supported and defended him the last time around. Yeah. Is that based off of truth, or is that based off of partisan politics coming from a place that talks about fair and balanced all the time? Come on, bro. There was one other part of, oh yeah, Liz Harrington. Yo, so I mean, my daily calls to CNN to have them air my show, The Watch List, every morning. They still haven't picked up on it yet. My First Amendment rights have been violated, and I want some satisfaction. I'm an American, damn it. I'm gonna make my call tomorrow, see if this gets fixed. This is a shame.
I know. There has not been a violation of First Amendment rights this bad since I told InfoWars they have to put TDR on. Because he was claiming when he was taken off of YouTube that that was a violation of his rights. Well, okay, I want access to your audience. Put me on, buddy. I don't actually want to be on InfoWars. But anyway, no, they don't understand any of this. And again, as I said, many people did play. I mean, hell, TYT played the majority of the speech. And it was covered pretty much everywhere. So in some cases, pretty irresponsibly though. C-SPAN tweeted out a section of the speech with this. This is the caption. Former President Trump concludes, "We will make America powerful again. We will make America wealthy again. We will make." I'm gonna stop there at that point. It goes on and on and on. I don't necessarily understand why C-SPAN like broadcasts the speech. That seems weird. But if they're gonna broadcast it, Jared, can we put that tweet back up again? Am I crazy? Or is that not how C-SPAN would normally put up a section of a speech?
I think
that looks like Trump's campaign tweeted that out.
Well, because I mean, they can go with this is what he said. We're just saying what he said. I've noticed some. I've been a very loyal C-SPAN watcher for about 15, 20 years now. Mm-hmm. It's weird. I go to that site a lot. There are some changes. They're doing different things with how they break it down, how they have access to different speeches. I actually appreciate C-SPAN as far as the way they break it down. I did know they tweeted this out this way, but I do think maybe they're, you know, the escape route. This is he said these things. All we're doing is saying what he said. Not that you have to agree or disagree. So I'm okay with them on that. But I think they're trying to get more accessibility, or at least more people going to them versus the, I guess, OANs that carried this.
Sure.
Okay, since it's an announcement.
I guess it just they put a lot of it up. That doesn't. How did they even fit that many letters in a tweet? That looks like twice as much of a tweet as most people get. I don't understand it.
Other people. Do they have a new blue check? Maybe it's a new feature.
Yeah. No. And look, I checked. It is the actual C-SPAN. It's official, by the way, according to Twitter, for whatever that's worth. And other people covered it too. The New York Post made sure that people knew about it with this, which I just love the Florida man makes announcement, page 26. Ouch. But some people did like it. Well, Fox officially might not support him, but Mike Huckabee was on Fox saying that Trump was unbeatable in 2024, which that's a bold claim. He literally lost the last time he raced. Now, he did also say that he didn't get why he was announcing now. He thinks it was a bad idea. So even the guy who says, oh no, he's totally gonna win is like, could you like wait until Herschel Walker has a chance of winning this thing? Is he gonna make him look really bad? And it's pretty clear coming out of that speech that Trump continues to want you to tie in your mind Herschel Walker to him. I'm perfectly happy with the voters having that in mind. I don't think it's going to help out Herschel Walker in this runoff.
Can I say one small thing about the what's his name, the idiot Huckabee? So you can say and criticize and talk about his timing of it, but at the same time say he's unbeatable. All that's doing is normalizing. Every time you hear something from even people who support him, like Huckabee, say something that's bad about his approach, a strategy, technique, policies, principles, any of that stuff. If you hear anything negative about this guy, you can bypass it and go back to, don't forget he's unbeatable though. That's the way that you put these people in these trances, so that no matter you hear about accusations, criminal issues, ineptitude when you're in office, all those things you hear constantly, you can always separate and go, yeah, those things happened, but he's unbeatable. From the same mouth of the guy who said he's unbeatable, he has issues. You can't say, hey, the Bucks and the NFL are going to win the Super Bowl this year, but they keep fumbling. Well, they can't win if they keep turning the ball over, bro. Which one is it? You can't say they're the best team, but then also they suck at what they do. One of the small intricate parts of the game that will determine wins and losses. Let's keep it real.
Yeah. No, I think you're right. And as a person who recently went to a Rams game, I get that analogy, and I'm right there with you, sports
all bro. On board. John, if he, you guys, if John's not here next week, he's got picked up for the head coaching position with the Rams.
I pretty much get it. You know, there's some passing, there's some running. You switch back and forth between the two, and then you probably get it done. Anyway, I want to talk about one other aspect of this. I would like to make a special comment slash request to the DOJ following Trump's announcement, and a little bit to the media too. I'm not as mad at the media when they say things like, well, indicting Trump is gonna be messier now, because they're not necessarily expressing their values. They're describing a situation. I still think it's a little bit apathetic and passive, but whatever, I'll give the media a pass on that. But when it comes to the DOJ, I know that even as I speak right now, Merrick Garland and a bunch of other people whose obligation, the entire point that they're drawing a salary as a member of the Department of Justice, is to enforce the law. Instead, they're sitting cloistered in a room like, I don't know if we can indict him. I mean, think about the things he will say. And everyone is worried about the things that he will say, and the things his defenders will say, and his spokespeople will say, and his surrogates will say. And here's the thing, they're right in that he will say many things. He'll say, they're only doing this because I'm a candidate. They're only doing this to take me down. They're trying to stop our movement. They will bleat and bleat and bleat that they're victims. But I will remind you, members of the DOJ and Merrick Garland, did you know that you have mouths too? Like the media figure, do you get that you can speak as well? That the people who will craft the narrative of what an indictment means will not exclusively be defenders of Donald Trump, or at the very least, they don't have to exclusively be those people. That when they come out and say, you're only coming after me because I've announced it for the presidency, you can respond quite accurately and quite rationally that you only announced so early, historically early, to ward off an indictment that you knew was coming. And regardless, you did the crime. At the end of the day, maybe if you didn't want to be targeted, don't make it so eminently easy to target you when you're committing the crime in the open and admitting it in your rallies. You guys can respond to this. Biden can give speeches. The January 6th commission, that may be gone with the House being destroyed, but every member of it, except for Liz Cheney and Kinzinger, are still there, and they can still go on the news. You guys can press the advantage, and in doing so, you can feel, I don't know, you can have the wind at your back by knowing that the American people in race after race after race have rejected Donald Trump. They've already given you the strong signal in rejecting so many of his strongly endorsed candidates that they're not on his side. They don't buy his claims about him being a massive martyr and a victim. And they do actually want some semblance of sanity and respect for the law. If that isn't going to make you feel comfortable wading into this messy area of indictment, then I don't know what will at this point. Bear, what do you think?
It's hard to add to that, John. That was excellent. It puzzles so many people trying to figure out the next steps here. And the way that they squeezed in, you talk about the loss of the House, where they squeezed in those last couple of January 6th committee hearings to allow people to see and give the opportunity for them to follow up on what we've seen, what we've heard, and what has been said. I believe there was even more things still coming out. Who was his accountant at the Trump org? Weisselberg?
Yeah. There were some apparently headlines today.
Still things happening there. Those things continue to change. And if you think Trump doesn't realize that, and the timing, as Huckabee was then saying, hey, that's the one weird thing with this timing. The one thing these guys who are now suddenly have the courage to say Donald Trump is a loser and we can't keep following him down this road, what they won't say is he's doing this because he's trying to get away from any and all responsibility for the things that he's been accused of. I was gonna say all the crimes he committed. We'll get there. But those things he's been accused of, they still can't say that part. That's the main reason. Because then maybe it might sweep them into this whole thing too, because they supported him while he was committing those crimes.
For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.